to Enox Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video I'm revisiting the tool setting gauge that I made about 3 years ago, and mainly because I wanted to see whether it still was accurate in that the fact that the height I'd got this set to was still the centre line of the headstock. And I say the centre line of the headstock because the headstock on most lathes doesn't move. When you're turning something in the chuck, it's the headstock that you need to set the tool to rather than the tailstock, which slides up and down and over years will wear. The tailstock base will wear and it will drop down, so you'd need to pack up the tailstock to put it back on centre. But by using this tool setting gauge, it works off the centre line of the machine. I'll also be showing you how to use slip gauges or gauge blocks, how you build up a block height for a certain size. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today I'm checking my tool height setting gauge and seeing how much the lathe has worn over the last 3 years and whether it's still reading correctly. Now to do that I need to put a dowel in the headstock. So the first thing I'm going to do is clean out the number 3 Morse taper and fit my collet, and in the end of the collet I'm fitting a dowel peg. This dowel is 3125, which is 516. Let's tighten this up. Doesn't need to be too tight. I'm only using it to measure. So with the 516 dowel in, we know where the centre line of the dowel is to the bottom. What I want to do is check where the face of my compound slide is to the centre line. Before I do that, I'll show you the tool I use for setting my tool height. The part is made from 3 pieces: a steel cylinder that's recessed at the bottom, flat on the top, a brass screw that goes through the side, and just a flat disc on this side with a shape on here so that when it fits on the dial indicator it locates on the body and clears the bezel. This goes then on the top, place it down onto a flat surface, lock the dial indicator so it just comes through the bottom, and then you can zero it. Now what I'm trying to work out now is the height from the top of the compound slide to that lip underneath, and whether that lip is on the centre line of the lathe. The way I'm going to do that is use some slip gauges or joey blocks or gauge blocks, depends what you want to call them. When I was in the tool room I used to call them slip gauges. Some of the older tool room people called them joey blocks because they were made by Johansson. I think that was the first person who made the set of slip gauges or gauge blocks. Now they tend to be called gauge blocks. This is one of the gauge blocks. This is a 1-inch one. And what I want to do is just check. When that slides under there, it just lifts the dial indicator up 2 thou. So that's not far out. So what I want to know is, what is the distance from the face to the underside of that dowel? The dowel size is 0.3125. Half of that is 0.15625. So I know it's 0.15625 from the centre line of the dowel to the underneath, which, if the height was 1 inch, would leave me 84375. Now I've built up the gauge blocks to 0.8437, and that is too big to fit under. So now what I'll do is just go down 2 thou, a bit lower, and that's 0.836. So I put slip gauges under the dowel and it came to 0.836 plus the 1.62, forget the 5, and that becomes 0.992, and my height gauge was set to 0.994, so I was 2 thou out. So the distance in slip gauges and half the dowel is 0.9922. So now I know the size from the centre to the top. So what I need on my centre finder, if I make up 0.992 and slip gauges, it should just slide under that centre finder. This is the set of gauge blocks I have. These are a workshop grade block. Well, I know you can get inspection grade, they are obviously more accurate. So these are just general workshop grade. And international inch at 68 degrees Fahrenheit just means when the temperature is 68 degrees Fahrenheit, they will be correct within their manufacturing limits. I don't have a calibration certificate for these. I got these for about £20 a couple of years ago. These are made by Coventry Gauge and Tool Company, and you get blocks going up in different sizes. I'll just point out these two blocks on the end here are protective slips. That's where we get the name slip gauges. These are protected slips. They are both 0.1, and the idea of this is if you're using the gauge blocks continuously set at a size, you could put one of these each side of the build-up so that the wear happens on these blocks and not on the set. I want to build up 0.9942. These go up in thous from 0.101. to 0.19. These go up in tenths, and then these are the odd block sizes between. So as I said before, you start with the lowest size, which would be the 2.0002, which is this one. There we go, 0.1002. So that's the first block. So now I have the 2. The next one is 4 thou. So here's my 4 thou block, 0.104. So if I add the 2 together, I've got 0.2042. Now I want 0.19, which is this block on the end. See there, 0.19. So I add that to the pack. Now I've built that pack up with 3 gauges and it comes to 0.3942. So all I need to do now is add the final block to make up the 0.9, which would be 0.6. This is already 0.3, so 0.6. So that stack now becomes 0.9942, which is what I need. Now I've set these slip gauges up, and what I have there is 0.9942, and we said that the center line distance was 0.9922, so I'm 2 thou higher on my tool setting gauge. When that finger moves, I know that I'm 2 thou above the centre height. Now I can take 2 thou off the bottom of that so I know it's right. I've just put an extra thou on this block set. So now when I push it under, you can see the dial indicator moves a thou. So that's telling me if that was my tool height, I would be a thou above, plus the other two thou that it is already out, so that's three thou above centre line. So I won't bother with the two thou. I know that if I can get my tool setting within two thou, that's ample, especially when you're doing forming, form tools and thread cutting. So what I've done, if I just recap, we put a dowel in the centre to give me the centre line of the headstock. I then halved the dowel, that's 0.3125, the dowel, half of that is 0.15625. And then originally I thought it was an inch from the compound slide to the centre line, but it's about 8 thou under. Over the years, as these slides are wearing, the whole thing is slowly dropping down, so that gap will get bigger if anything. So I'll leave my setting gauge as it is and just show you how it works. One thing I'll point out about the slip gauges or gauge blocks, always start with the smallest size and add the blocks up till you get the correct size. To check the tool height, all I do is put the tool in the holder, swing it round. That should slide under there. That height is too high. Just tighten the tool holder up. So all I do is lower the tool down till the gauge drops over the top, and then lift the tool up till it moves and lock it in position. Now that tool is on centre line. Turn it round. And I can do that with my boring bars or anything that I need to put on centre line. Just bring it back over. Do it again. I undo the slacken off the adjusting clamp, lower the tool, then just nip the clamp so I can raise the tool, make sure it's just on the edge of the lip. As that dial indicator moves, tighten the tool. Just a couple of thou over. And just turn it round. If I put a centre in the tailstock, I was trying to set that to the centre. Because it's not got a sharp point on the centre, it's difficult to tell where the centre is. Let me bring that over. Now on that it looks above, so if I set it to the centre, I would say it's probably there. The headstock, it doesn't move, so this is the centre line of the headstock. The tailstock, you're pushing it backwards and forwards, this has probably dropped over the years because obviously you've got wear on the bottom of the slides for the tailstock. Now this has been set with the centre and as you can see it's leaving a small pip on the end of the bar. So now I'll reset the tool. Now I'm going to set it to the tool gauge, which is there. No pip on the brass. Always set your dial indicator to zero when you place it on the compound slide. You can set your boring bar, your parting off tools and your lathe tools with that. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.